What's going on, guys? So in today's video, it was pretty loud out, so most of this is gonna be a voiceover, and I recorded everything. But basically, what I am showing you guys is some of the first mods that I've done onto my 2018 STI, the new car that I just got. And obviously, since it's such a new car, such low miles, and I worked so hard for it, what better thing to do first than to add some stuff to protect it? So what I actually decided to do for my first set of mods for this car is the first thing is some door ding guards. Those were very, very, very important. I mean, I'm sure you guys know cars all the time get door dings. So I decided to install some OEM door ding guards on this car. I'll show you guys that. Of course, I have some footage for in this video of that, setting that up. I also installed a vortex generator on the car, as well as a front lip. The OEM front lip. Everything that's in this video is completely OEM from Subaru. None of it is like aftermarket parts. It's all like, let's say if I bought the car brand spanking new and I wanted to option stuff, that's basically what this stuff would be. So front lip, we got that. We got the vortex generator. We got the door ding guards, and we also got some new fog light covers. I'm installing that all in this video. The first thing that I went ahead and did is the door ding guard. So basically, they give you these templates. I line it up perfectly, take off the 3M tape on the back, and then the door ding guards just go right in place, and you hold them and they're perfect. It was so easy to install. You know, I thought it would be difficult, but it overall was just so easy. Next up, we have these fog lights. So there's the 2018 fog light covers and the 2020s. I thought to myself that the 2020s just look so much better. They also give you increased airflow, more of a space for airflow, so I thought, why not? So I got those, and they have an extra gloss finish on the sides, and they just look a lot better and a lot more aggressive. So I was really excited to pick up those. That was one thing that I really wanted on the 2020, but I got the 2018 instead to save some money. So I got one of the things that I really wanted on the 2020, which was those fog light covers. So the old ones versus the new ones, I just think it's a huge difference. Then we have the vortex generator here. So you might be asking yourself, Shock, does this do anything? And to answer that question, I would have to say yes. There's little scientific research that does show that vortex generators on a car, especially when a car has a huge wing like this, the vortex generator may like adjust the wind a little bit better to go through the wing. I mean, it's honestly more for protection and looks over performance. Like you'd have to probably be going 120 on the highway and going around corners to see any difference in performance with this vortex generator. It's honestly just for looks and protection. So I decided to pick it up, and it's an OEM piece. So what I did is I put the backing tape for the 3M that comes all set up. I put it on the front top. So basically what I could do, I could put it in place, see if it was perfect, right? So you want to make sure that fitment is perfect. I put it in place with masking tape and everything, made sure everything was perfect and lined up. And then what I went ahead and do is slowly took off the backing tape. And once that backing tape was all off, press firmly, and she is on. Really nice, really good. I mean, it just fits so good. Oh, I love OEM stuff. If you guys don't know what that is, it basically means original manufacturer equipment. So basically everything is lined up, all the holes are perfect, everything is perfect. You don't have to change anything, you don't have to cut wires, do anything, adjust this, you know, anything like that. You don't have to sand that down, do anything. The front lip was so easy too. All the holes were basically there for the front lip. I just had to screw them in, and that was basically it. And it came with instructions as well, and I had some YouTube videos that I could look up for the front lip. The front lip was so easy to install. So easy. I definitely recommend it if you are someone looking for one. But yeah, so that was the last thing that I installed. All right, guys, so before I end off the video, just to go over a recap of what we did today. So today I installed this completely OEM vortex generator, which fit on perfectly, nice and sturdy.
helps with the airflow to the wing and just helps with protection aspects and as well as just aesthetics. And then what we also did, these are very, very, very important. These are door ding protectors or door guards, whatever you would like to call them. But these are gonna work amazing, especially, you know, just against door dings when I'm in a parking lot or anything. So those were really, really important. And then we also installed this completely OEM front lip. It only lowers the car barely, really barely an inch. So we still have like 5 inches of ground clearance. And honestly, it looks amazing and still has so much ground clearance. But so we did that, and we also did the 2020 fog light covers, which allows more airflow into there as well. But the front lip is just gonna be amazing. I love how it looks. It looks amazing for OEM. The fitment is really good. It's really sturdy, really on there. But yeah, the front lip can help. You know, that would be the first thing to damage, to get damaged if I hit anything, instead of the bumper itself. So this was overall, you know, mostly protection mods that I did. I'm also going to be doing some type of a mud guard that goes here. I might include that in the video, but I'm not sure. But they're called rear aero splash guards. It just helps with rocks slinging up and stuff and hitting the bumper. So I will be installing that at some point. But other than that, that's gonna wrap up today's video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to drop a like, guys, and I'll catch you in my next video. Peace out, guys. Face it, bust it.